Hello friends, in this video let us analyze the important questions that was asked on 3rd December 2019 of electronic science paper. Starting with first question, they have asked number of poles that is residing on right half of S plane. They have given the characteristic equation you have to solve. The second question was based on you have to identify the type of system given the transfer function C of S divided by R of S, which is equals to 16 divided by s square plus 8s plus 16. So omega n you will be getting the value as 4 and zeta you will be getting 1, hence the system is critical damped. Third question was based on assertion and reasoning. They have given the gain margin definition. First assertion was based on magnitude definition and the second one was based on phase. So reason is not the correct explanation for assertion, but both statements are correct, hence the answer is B. Fourth question, they have asked in optic fibers why cladding is used. We know that the signal is carried by core and core is surrounded by cladding. Cladding is used to give protection. So they have given the option as to maintain refractive index, to avoid interference, to give strength. Like that they have given the option. Fifth question was based on you have to derive the relation between Y parameters and T parameters. Nothing but match the following. You have to match for Y11, Y12, Y21 and Y22. And sixth question, you have to arrange mobility of holes in descending order. They have given carbon, gallium arsenide, silicon carbide and germanium. Somehow you relate with respect to mobility of electrons. So mobility of electrons in the case of gallium arsenide, it is 8500. In the case of germanium, it is 3500. In the case of silicon, it is 1800. For that you are going to add carbon, so it is silicon carbide. So whenever you are going to add dopants, mobility decreases. You know mobility of electrons. We know mobility of electrons is greater than mobility of holes. Relate with this and solve the problem. And we know carbon is a good insulator. Seventh question, they have given reflected wave is half of incident wave. Reflection coefficient gamma equals to 0.5. So to calculate standing wave ratio, rho is given by 1 plus gamma divided by 1 minus gamma, which is equals to 1 plus 0.5 divided by 1 minus 0.5, which is equals to 1.5 divided by 0.5, which is equals to 3 divided by 1. So the ratio is 3:1, you have to specify. Eighth question, given some set of data values, you have to calculate radiated power. Ninth question, they have given 4 statements. Out of these 4 statements, you have to pick 2 statements which are correct. So first statement was based on gun diode and UJT, which is acting like an amplifier, true. And UJT is having negative resistance. Yes, UJT is having negative resistance, hence it is acting like a relaxation oscillator. 10th question was based on EDC. For one-sided abrupt junction, determine effective width. For an N plus P, depletion width will be on P side. For P plus N, depletion width will be more on N side. This concept you have to remember. And we know 1 by N effective, which is equals to 1 divided by NA plus 1 divided by ND. For this, option number A is correct. Effective width W equals to under root of 2 epsilon S VBI divided by Q times of N effective. 11th question was based on small signal gain expression for common emitter amplifier. We know common emitter or common source is going to produce a phase shift of 180 degree. So you have to hunt for minus sign. 3 options was based on plus sign and 1 option was on negative sign. So you have to opt for that negative sign. 12th question, you have to match the following: voltage series, voltage shunt, current series, current shunt. On the other side, they have given voltage amplifier, current amplifier, transconductance, trans resistance. So voltage series, first term corresponds to output and second term corresponds to input. So voltage means on the output you are taking voltage, nothing but parallel connection, nothing but you are doing voltage sampling. On the input side, you are going to do series, nothing but series mixing, you are doing voltage. So voltage series corresponds to voltage amplifier. Like that you have to solve. 13th question, discrete in time is in Laplace transform, Z transforms, Fourier transforms, FFT. We know in the case of fast Fourier transforms, you are having 2 methods. One is DIT FFT and DIF FFT. Hence, the option is option number 4 is correct. 14th question, you have to identify the number of breakpoints. For a fourth order system, how you're going to find the breakpoint is dk by ds, you have to equate to 0 and then you have to solve for the value of s. 15th question, they have given four statements again. Tm equals to eta times of square root of 1 minus fc by f the whole square, true. Statement 2, t equals to eta divided by square root of 1 minus fc by f the whole square, true. Statement 3, they have given z equals to 1 divided by eta, it is false. 16th question, they have given four transducers, you have to identify which is passive transducer. And 17th question was based on, if the wave is moving along y direction having an amplitude ex, they have given some equation and they have given some four statements. The first statement was, is it a scalar, and remaining options was also there. 18th question, the question was based on how you are going to increase the ammeter range. So we know that in order to increase the ammeter range, the extra resistance what you have to connect, you have to connect in parallel, nothing but shunt connections you have to make. Series connection you are going to do in voltmeter, and in the case of voltmeter, for that extra resistance is made up of swamping. 19th question, for the given combinational circuit, you have to find the expression for F. Look at over here, it is A plus A into B, that is A only. And next one is B plus AB, which is equals to B, and they have given this value. So based on that, you have to get the expression for F. 20th question, mod 50 counter can be realized using mod 5 followed by mod 10. 5 number of mod 10 counters, 10 number of mod 5 counters they have asked. What do you mean by mod 50 counter, which is going to count from 0 to 49? 21st question, for a serial communication, which one you are going to prefer? SMOD, SCON, TCON, SBUF. 22nd question was based on microcontroller. They have given move A, some data and they have performed 3 times right shift through carry flag. So you have to tell what is the value of accumulator at last. 23rd question was based on microcontroller 8051. They have given move A, some value. Next expression was add A, some value. After performing addition, you should tell what is the value of carry flag, what is the value of parity flag, and what is the value of auxiliary flag. For all these things, I got option as 1. I don't remember the exact values over here. So if you can able to remember, just put it in the comment box. 24th question was based on digital storage oscilloscope, and 25th question again it was on match the followings. They have given successive approximation, straight away I have related to binary search, and you know a dual slope makes use of linear search. Bit error rate, BPSK, PFSK, DPSK they have given, and on the other side the options was ERCOF under root of EB by 2N0, ERCOF under root of EB by N0 and exponent of EB by N0, like that they have given the options. And 27th question was easy question. They have asked the current expression in diode, the current expression in PN junction, the current expression in MOSFET, the current expression in JFET they have asked. And 28th question was based on time domain equation. For this you have to write the time domain equation. So if you are having a slope, that is R of T. If you are having some unit step, that is U of T, and right shift is minus, left shift is plus, like that you have to solve. And 29th question, you have to write the Laplace equation. So if you are having a ramp, it is 1 divided by S square. If you are having a step, it is 1 by S, like that you have to solve. 30th question was based on DC motors, and 31st question was also on based on DC motors. And 32nd question, they have given the question based on AC generator and DC generator. 33rd question, statement 1 they have given SR is a semi-transparent, and statement 2 they have given based on SR only. And 34th question was based on signal flow graph. Now let us understand that we are having two nodes, the ith node and we are having jth node. Whenever the signal is flowing from I to J, that means on the J side you have to consider the signal value as positive. And 35th question was an easy question. You have to write the frequency range of L band, S band, Q band and K band. How to remember is LX, CX, Q, K, K. Like that you can remember. 36th question was based on satellite operates in dash range. Gigahertz, megahertz, hundreds of gigahertz, kilohertz. And 37th question was based on resistivity expression. This question they have asked n number of times. So resistivity is given by 1 divided by sigma. So sigma is given by nq mu n plus pq mu b in the case of semiconductors. In the case of metals, it is nq mu n. 30th question. Aspect ratio of pull-up network and pull-down network for an NMOS driven by another NMOS inverter. So you have to know what is the ratio. So we know for the depleted mode NMOS transistor, the threshold voltage is negative. So negative was the hint. Based on that, you have to solve. 39th question. Figure of merit for DSBSC is 0, 1, 2 divided by 2 plus mu square, and one more option was 0.5. So the answer is 2 divided by 2 plus mu square. And what do you mean by figure of merit? The figure of merit is the product of power dissipation multiplied by propagation delay. And 41st question was based on oxidation. Which oxidation is good? Wet oxidation, dry oxidation, hydrochloric oxidation. 42nd question was based on base and collector of BJT. Which one is lightly doped? And 43rd question, to decrease the ripples, frequency has to be increased, frequency has to be decreased. Similar to this, the question was framed. We know to decrease ripples, frequency should be more. So in order to convert from AC to DC, we are going to make use of rectifiers. And again, for smoothening the waveform, we are going to make use of capacitive filters. Followed by, we are going to make use of voltage regulators. But when you are going to make use of capacitive filters, ripples will be there. In order to minimize the discharging time, we are going to increase the frequency. 44th question was based on Schmitt trigger. They have given the definition of Schmitt trigger. We know any sine wave can be converted into rectangular wave or square wave in the case of Schmitt trigger. They have asked Schmitt trigger makes use of a negative feedback. False. Schmitt trigger always makes use of a positive feedback. 45th question, you have to identify the combinational circuits. First option, they have given full adder. Second option, shift register. Third option, multiplexer, and so on. We know full adders, multiplexers, demultiplexers, encoder, decoder, priority encoder, even half subtractor and full subtractor also belongs to combinational circuits. Sequential circuits are the one which will be having memory with it. The examples of sequential circuits are shift registers, counters, flip-flop, latch. All this falls under sequential circuits. 46th question was based on information theory and coding. You have to tell the correct expression for information content, that is I. 47th question, you have to arrange the entropy in descending order. So we know if the probability is equal for each and every symbol, then entropy is maximum, or entropy is maximum if the symbols are equiprobable. So this will be having maximum entropy. That entropy value I got 2. How entropy is defined? H equals to summation I varying from 0 to n minus 1 pi log of 1 by p. So based on that, I have solved and I have got the answer. 48th question, you have to arrange the flag registers of microcontroller 8051 in particular order. 49th to 54th question was based on scaling. This time UGC NET board has shocked us because after long back they are asking this question. So you have to tell the scaling factor of gate capacitance. We know gate capacitance C equals to epsilon A by D. How area is scaled? 1 by alpha square. And how D is scaled? It is 1 by beta. So based on that, you have to solve. And current density, which is I by A. We know the current expression is mu n C ox W by L into VGS minus VTH the whole square. Mu n, no need to scale. C ox is nothing but epsilon ox by T ox. So T ox is scaled by 1 by beta. And VGS minus VTH, nothing but voltage term, is scaled by beta. Based on that, you have to solve and you have to get the expression. And power dissipation, we know we are having two types of power dissipation. One is static power dissipation and dynamic power dissipation. Static power dissipation is 0. And dynamic power dissipation is given by half FCL VDD square. And then you have to solve. And another two questions they have given based on scaling only. I expected some good questions on networks, especially based on theorems. And I also expected questions on radars, Nyquist plot and Bode plot, even on transmission line and waveguides. And also I expected some good questions on digital electronics, that is on A2D converters and D2A converters. This time they have not asked the question based on LVDT or errors. Instead, they have asked question on sharing bridge. And I didn't find some good questions even on analog communications also. Overall, paper 1 was moderate to difficult and paper 2 was easy to moderate. And theory 2 problematic if I am taking, they have given 70 questions and problematic, they have given some 30 questions. And good weightage was given to EDC, VLSI, instrumentation, EMTL, microwaves and electrical. And I also expected some good questions on radars and networks. Time was sufficient and you can answer all 100 questions easily. You can see the paper analysis of electronic science first in Craving Gyan. So to keep updated with things, kindly like this video, share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to get instant notification whenever I upload a new video. Thank you. All the best for your exams.